So, welcome back. We now would like to review the sample solutions.
Yep.
And let's jump right into it. So the first task was the constructor injection. Actually, that was the demo, so we will not go very deeply in that. But maybe some of you realized that we had something missing in there, which was not that obvious. And that is, we did not really test if this sort did work. I mean, we covered it, so it was executed during our test, but it was not really tested if it's there at all. We could delete that line, mm-hmm. and our test would not recognize it. So why is that? Let's see what our test double was providing. Our test double in the demo was providing only the amount equals 5. But that means it only provided one line. And if we look back to the product code, it's sorting that returned table and then taking the first line. So because we only provided one line, we also can skip the sort and it does the same thing. So we did not test the sort. And to prevent that, to fix that, we added two more lines in this return table in the stub here and put the one we want in the middle, so it's no longer line number one. So if we now would delete mm-hmm. the sort, it would mm-hmm. fail, our test would fail. So this just as an addition to the demo.
Right.
Maybe some of you realized that and did not do the same or did not have the same glitch in their code. Okay, now go to the next one. That was the setter injection. So what did we have to do there? First of all, we need the setter as a method here. So that's this line here. And this is, of course, not optional because the only purpose is to right. feed in yeah. the cache provider. And we still need the cache provider as a member variable. And then the rest is basically the same. In the code under test, this line which was there before with the new is gone, but we have the implementation of the setter down here, which just puts the setter on the member variable, and that's it. And from the test code side, it's also very similar. So the cache provider is for all examples exactly the same, so I will no longer show it. And the only difference is that now instead of passing in the test double in the constructor, we have to call this extra method. So no other difference. Okay, right. Next one.
But before that, maybe yeah? just why would you do a setter injection? I think sometimes it is the simplest thing to do when you have a class that you need to somehow decouple from some dependent on component, and you can, if you do it in the constructor, you have maybe many places where you have to, where you're creating these instances and then you have to go everywhere or make it
yes.
optional or all these things.
Yes.
So you can make it optional, but a setter injection sometimes is an easy thing to do. And so you can see how easy it is this way basically to decouple from your dependent on component.
Yeah, correct. Okay, then parameter injection. Let's start with the product code. So here parameter injection means we have it as an extra parameter on our code under test. And as you can see, it's not really nice because you have it now in this method, in the next method here, and yeah, and then you have this extra code in here which needs to decide, was it provided, was it not provided, and yeah, it just blows up your mm-hmm. product code. It's a possibility, but we would rather not go
right.
for it, yeah. But we wanted to show it for completeness.
And again, I think it's, if you think about like legacy code where you have a big class and maybe 100 methods and there's only one that you need to test now and with one injection, you know, you don't want to change everything. So it may be a small incremental step, but if you have more of this, then you would of course somehow take it either to a setter or a constructor injection because you
yeah.
don't want to repeat code like this.
Yeah.
And it pollutes the interface.
Yeah, as you can see here, many places where you have to add
right.
that. And then also in the test code, also many places. Yeah, here the setup stays the same, our test double stays the same, but every test has to be touched and the cache provider mm-hmm. test double has to be created there and passed in there. So that's not really a good way to go. Okay, now backdoor injection. Also start with the product code again. Looks pretty much the same. So we have a member variable mm-hmm. here, and actually we have a constructor which creates the cache provider for us.
Yeah. The real one now.
The real one. Yeah. And now let's go to the test code. What does the test code do? And the test code, first of all, has to get friends with the global class, with our global class here. And that is the statement we also showed you in a former unit. So we first have to do the definition deferred here. And then we have to extend the definition of the global class with this local friends statement and make this test class friend of the local of the global class. And that is the first thing to do. And the second thing is then in the setup here, we have to modify this member variable and put our mm-hmm. test double on it. And we are only allowed to do so because we are friend of
right.
this. Yeah. So this is the twist with backdoor injection.
Yeah, and I think it's interesting to note that the real one was already created, so hopefully it wasn't too expensive to do this.
Yeah.
And you're overriding it and throwing the real one away. So this is something that if you don't want to touch the product code or something, or maybe even whatever it is, so maybe it's also created later that there is a lazy instantiation yeah. of the provider that you don't know. But the point here is to show the friendship kind of to
deal yes,
and
yes,
how
yes.
that works. And one other point about friendship is, of course, that the direction of how you can declare friendship. So you can, of course, only say from the inside out, you are allowed to be my friend and not the other way around.
Mm-hmm.
But since we are in the same class environment in the test include, we can do this, right?
Yeah. So this local friend statement is only possible in the same unit.
In the test include.
Other
same unit, yeah.
If you want to declare other classes as your friend, then it's global friends. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
that's the syntax there. But for the test, local friends is the mm-hmm. one you use.
Exactly.
Because actually you cannot tell the compiler global friends and my test class is my global friend. Your test class is
not global.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And it's yeah. for testing, and that's mm-hmm. another thing which prevents that. Okay. That was this. And now we have the second task was to do the same thing, basically. But now you have this extra step because there mm-hmm. is no interface. And so what does that mean? So first of all, coming from the product side, we still have our member variable, which is now typed with the local interface which you created. And then the rest here is the same. And now let's see what implications does that have to have this local interface. First of all, because of this line here, and that I mentioned in the demo, you have in this tab strip here, in this include, this class relevant local type to tell the compiler, by the way, there will be LIF cache provider interface soon, so it's deferred. And the compiler now knows, okay, there will be one, and therefore it will compile the product mm-hmm. Code. And then, of course, you have to provide a real one. Mm-hmm. That's what we do in the next include here. And here we just simulate the interface method we need to forward to the real thing. And so we define it, and then we need a definition and the implementation of a local productive class which does this delegation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and this one implements this interface we just created.
Right.
So this is the extra step you have to go. And here you just see we delegated to the real thing, which is in this case this cache provider static. And we call this static method here, pass in the currency and get back what this method is getting us back to mm-hmm. our caller.
So basically, to be able to switch the dependency between the real thing and the test double, you have to kind of wrap it in this
yes.
local class, and you switch it with the interface.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this trick you can do with all things which are in the way and don't have an interface mm-hmm. to implement. Yeah, like we mentioned earlier in the units, function calls can go in here, body calls mm-hmm. and all stuff
right.
like that you can get rid of with this little trick.
Right. I think the real trick, the hard point is always when you want to make a change in a class that you do not own.
Yes.
And then if you can't do that, you have to create your own class as an indirection, and everything you need from that you would put on there, and the rest you would leave out.
Yeah.
Which is also a good pattern, I suppose, to be explicit of what you need from
yeah.
the service class.
And if you have many, many classes which need this delegation, mm-hmm. then you would do it as a global interface in your space
right.
and a global implementation of this delegation also in your space.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but we have still the test part missing here. And okay, the test double still the same. And also here, the implementation on this side, it's identical to the one we just showed before mm-hmm. in the backdoor injection, because we asked you also to use the backdoor injection here.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no difference, even though we are using a different interface. The only difference is our cache provider here. It's implementing the local interface
mm-hmm.
instead of the global interface.
Yep.
Okay, so that was the review for the exercise. And hope you enjoyed it. And this was the last unit of this week.
Mm-hmm.
So
look at your weekly assignment.
Weekly assignment, and use the forum if you have questions. And we are looking forward.
See you next week.
To see you next week, yeah. Bye.